Hello, friend. Jim here with JB's Big Adventure, coming to you from Lake Chapala, Mexico. About 3 months ago, when I first started my YouTube channel, I put out a video basically of, okay, you've decided that you want to move to Mexico. Now what comes next? What I've done is I've taken some portions out of that video and made them just smaller. That way there's more videos and you're able to find the portion of that video to watch that you want to watch that's pertinent for you. And in this one here, I'm talking about, for one, the options of coming down to Mexico, driving down. And there's like three options you can choose from that. And then I talk about the importance of each one of the steps, including even once you get to the border, what happens when you're with your boxes and things at the border itself with customs. So I think you'll find this very, very valuable for you in regards to your move here to Lake Chapala. So let's go ahead and go to the video.
Okay, so now we're going to talk about driving a vehicle down to Lake Chapala. Now, if you have sold everything and all you're bringing is a few suitcases inside your vehicle, that will be option number one. The scenario number two is driving a car or a truck with a trailer yourself down to Lake Chapala. The third would be driving a vehicle such as with a U-Haul trailer or a truck down to the border yourself. Then use a service where your items are actually taken off of your trailer and put into someone else's trailer or truck that came up from Lake Chapala, and then they drive them down, you follow them down, and they take your items to your house, condo, apartment, or even your storage unit. So as mentioned, we chose option number three. So what we did was we filled a small 5x8 U-Haul trailer with just a small bit of items, drove them down to the border at Laredo. A gentleman drove up from Lake Chapala to meet us at the border. We took the items out of our trailer, put them on his trailer, and he told us he was in a double tarp or everything. Well, on the way down, it rained. When the items were actually delivered to our storage unit, boxes were coming off the trailer. They were wet, falling apart. So we lost a lot of things. So option number three is a great option. Just make sure you check into who the individual is going to be doing it for you and also get some references. So let's go ahead and talk about our next subject, and that is driving down with a trailer. So now what we're going to talk about is if you plan on option number three in regards to towing a trailer down with a car. We actually drove down a 5x8 trailer because we didn't have a whole lot of things that we were bringing down. Now, our car did not have a hitch. We had to check into seeing how much of a weight it could actually tow. So we were told 2,000 pounds. So we had to actually buy some items and have a mechanic actually attach them to the car, which is a trailer hitch, the electronic harness for brake lights, a drawbar, a 2-inch ball hitch, also a lock pin so the trailer itself can't be stolen. And we also took U-Haul's insurance just because if something happened to the trailer, it would be covered. So we'll go to our next subject with driving down expenses. Okay, so now what we're going to cover is the driving down expenses and what to expect. And I just want to let you know, it's a 12-hour drive down. We broke it up into 2 days, so we stayed halfway down at the hotel down there. And I would just share with you that you just want to make sure gas, it's probably going to cost you somewhere around $200 if you're driving a car. And there will be OXXO's, O-X-X-O, and sometimes they have gas stations. They're kind of like a U.S. 7-Eleven. So you just want to make sure that you keep your gas tank filled. You're going to have tolls as you go down. You're probably going to have $100 to $150 that you'll be paying in tolls. And then whatever food that you want to take down, even to munch. So those are kind of the things regards to expenses that you're going to have. And the biggest one's probably going to be the gas, just because of the fact that you'll make sure it's, the tank's full. Okay, so I'm wrapping up with this slide just so you're aware of when you're holding on to things or when you're going to go ahead and keep things and bring them down. This is something that you're going to want to know about. So what to expect at the border? Well, I will tell you that customs has all the right of having you unload your truck or taking everything off of your trailer. Now, this was something that was given to me as a heads up. As you'll see on the left, there's box numbers. On the right, there's like a list of what's in those boxes. Now, when we went across, we had actually a flatbed trailer that had all of our things, and they took one look at our sheet and then automatically made an idea, came up with a number, because they can charge you 18% of the value that they see that's in your items. So we made a manifest to make sure that if they were going to look at something or need us to tell them what was in a certain number of box, we already had this list made. Now, after looking at a few of the boxes, they made a determination that we owed them $400 in U.S. dollars in tariff. Now, I negotiated them to pay $300, but it ended up being, I got told later on, I could have actually negotiated even more. So this is something just to keep in mind regards to when you're looking at bringing things with you, to make sure you're putting numbers on boxes and then you're creating a list. Okay, well, I hope this has been really helpful for you. Talking about now you've made a decision to move to Lake Chapala, Mexico, and these are all the things that you're going to need to make sure that you know about and helps you have a successful and an enjoyable trip.
Okay, so there you go. All the things that are important for you if you're planning on driving a vehicle down to Mexico and what you'll need to do, the steps for that. So if you haven't already, I'd like to encourage you to go ahead and subscribe to the channel. It's a great community and you don't want to be outside of that. On top of that, give us a thumbs up. There'll be other folks that want to move down to Lake Chapala. And when you give a thumbs up, it helps the algorithms within YouTube of videos that they are also looking for. Two, go ahead and smash the bell, because what happens is when you do that, you're immediately notified when our next video comes out. And also, if you'd like to comment, either would be maybe another video you'd like to see made of Lake Chapala or questions you might have and such, you can do that and we'd love to communicate with you. So with that, thank you so much for being a part of this video. Have an awesome day and we'll see you on the next video.